take my decision and give my opinion on brain drain has to be stopped. We all know that in our country there are several graduates passing out year by year. So the government couldn't provide good employment facilities to all of us. So many skilled people are moving to foreign countries in order to develop themselves and self-development. But these people are not self-motivated and not showing their patriotism to our country for becoming a good development nation. Even the graduates goes to foreign countries, my opinion is that they should return back our country within a short span of time, and they should develop our country so that our country will become a developed one within a short span of time.
Yes, my dear friend, you are right. I agree with you. So what is brain drain? What it itself signifies that a brain is getting drained up by this our technology, our skill and innovations. With many of ideas from our country, graduates may move to the foreign countries for the skill and the respect for a better environment. So going there is not wrong at all, but they should come back and in the best ways and utilize their brains in our country development. Within few years, our country can be a developed country.
Yes, my dear. It is very so sad that India, a developing nation, but it is discovered that brain drain is one of the major problems that is facing by India today. So it is very sad that many skilled, technically qualified doctors, scientists and many more who are very skilled are migrating to other countries. But I don't know why, because it is very initiative responsibility by every citizen of India to make a part in the development of our country. But instead of developing, instead of taking a responsibility, but our country is just going back. But why? Because due to the brain drain. What do you say, man?
Yes, my friend. I also agree with you. But it's why this brain drain has happened? To government responsible to take the initiation to give you some more products to engineers. We have great engineers and doctors, but they are like to go to the other countries because of their some of infrastructures are very good and they have very lot of opportunities there. Because government was to take initiation to coming back to them, I think.
Yes, my dear friend, I agree with you. India has the second largest number of scientists and doctors. 40% of the people, scientists are coming from India in NASA. You are working extraordinary.
Yes, my dear friend, I agree with you. But I would like to add one point. The migration of scientists and doctors, technically qualified, reasonably developed and underdeveloped country, but most of the education people are
skilled and technically developed in their education.
Yes, my friend, I agree with you. But only government provides is not important, but also people mindset is also different. They want to feel they are proud in the nation. They want to go in out countries and they can gain more name and they can money. Our parents also wants to. My son is studying in foreign countries and he was developed in many creations in foreign countries. But they can't think our nation, what happened to our nation, why we can't, why we can go to the our other nations and we are working at there, and why India was not developing and still developing. They want to develop and come back to the India.
Yes, my dear friend, I agree with you. Many engineers, doctors, scientists are studying and devoted to the education, and they are well trained up in our India. But due to the less facilitating in our country, less companies, and the job opportunity is decreasing, unemployment. So they want the education system, what they are trained up. They are not comfortable with our country, so they are migrating to the abroad because of this. Still, India is a developing country, so government has to provide right facilities to our country.
Yes, I agree with you, but I want to share my views that. Not only government facilities, every individual should have a mindset that they should share their ideas to their own motherland or own country. But nowadays the people are so partial that they want to gain more money, not only serving motherland. In this way they are moving to abroad to gain more money for their own sake.
Since 1947 we got independence, right? But still we are not independent, we depend on other countries for this job seeking, some other else. But every person, if a graduate, a well-skilled person, technological person, they go to the foreign countries for better facilities and for better employment. But you think that he should love his motherland, right? He should come back again to the motherland, because motherland is just like a mother. How can we leave a mother and go back? How can he go back when he leaves his motherland? He should come back with his own technical skill and knowledge to develop our country. If he won't come back, he will still be lag behind. Still be lag behind in many factors. If he come back and he develop our country, then our country can be well groomed up in many stages, like in technology, in innovations.
Good examples.
So I have an example, right? As you all know about our ex president, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. He's also studied his schooling and everything in abroad, but he won't come back to our country. Then we miss our Agni missile and Prithvi missile. So these are the missiles which can't compete the Britishers with these missiles. So if he came back, there is a reason we groomed up in all these missiles and the NASA. If he won't come back, we can't develop these missiles again.
Generation.
It's very good point, but I do want to add you a small point with you. According all, as we all know that UNDPA, United Nations Development Program, so it is a combination of different countries for the sake of development to the poor, under poor and very poor. So it is estimating that every year India is losing 5 billion crores, that means $5 billion when it come back. So India is losing $5 billion per year in the form of foreign exchange. So when a student deserves to study in abroad, so a survey conducted by IIM, Indian Institute of Management, which is at Bangalore, so it is stating that when in 2000 census, in the year of 2000, a number of students has went is 50,000. So it's very sad that it has shot up the figure of 1.9 lakhs in the span of 10 years. So how the passports,
the people are running for the gain of passports. So instead of running for the development of a nation, so my friend, what your decision for this? What do you suggest for this?
Government should provide a right, should take a right decision.
Yes, my dear friend, I agree with you. But if we take in the world, every 5 members they watch Indian in every country. Because this shows our methodology of Indians, which are, they want to go to the foreign countries for their development. Shows the, for take any country in the world, there was a 1 member which is 5 members of that country. It shows our methodology of interest to go to the other countries. What do you say?
That's my difference. I agree with you, but I would like to add a point. In recent years, we are moving to the other countries such as Iran and Iraq, where there are many foreign players. So, not only America, not only Japan, in the field of technology, our students are going for other countries to develop themselves. But why are they not concentrating? We all know that India is a land of many technological and many fields. We have many opportunities in our country, but we too, as our individual, we are not using those facilities and making our nation a self-developed one.
Yes, well, it is right. Every year, 5,000 doctors and 8,000 scientists still there are in the foreign countries. If we get back the scientists and the doctors from to our country, we can make wonders in each and every field, right?
Yes, ma'am, I agree with you, but most of the people are going to the other countries. Why they are going to the main problem is India was completely dependent on agriculture development and also they improving for the national development. Indian government was not ready to support everything. But Indian government was still developing, but the politicians are very bad. They can't support in students because they are being selfish. They behave like also selfish. They want more money, but they want need to develop our nation.
So India should implement a rule. A person who crosses a salary 1 lakh above, he should adopt 2 children from orphanage so that the poor people can get better education. So why the main people go back to foreign countries? The main reason is India can't provide better facilities. They can't pay high salary. Can't give much facilities to the most difficult persons. If the persons who are better skilled and the better knowledge, if we give them the same priority which they get in foreign countries, obviously they come back to our country, right?
That's my difference with you. When we observe, go through the war, we can observe all Indians in the all over world. As well as in India, we can observe all foreigners, but the foreigners who are coming to our India, they are acquiring knowledge and go back to the countries and develop other nations. But our Indians were still there to develop themselves. What about your views about this point?
Yes, my dear friend. So our political leaders should take responsibility by giving good employment skills. They should talk to foreign industries and they should introduce many industries and they should provide good employment facilities in our country, then this will reduce some brain drain in our country.
Yes, my dear friend, I will agree with you, but I want to add a new point. Now, in establishing an industry in India, we require raw materials. But in India, the raw material is very less. We should export the material from the other countries. So, the scientists or industrial people are mainly going to abroad or USA to settle themselves as they can save money or securing raw materials.
Last one.
As a brain drain may be a great curse for India. Not only India, the countries which are developing and underdeveloped. So every individual and every citizen of the one's country has to take a responsibility to make their nations to convert from developing to develop. So it is a very, very main responsibility to be a citizen of India, a citizen of country.
Every year, doctors and scientists, a doctor adds 33 lakhs to the worth of USA, and a scientist adds 18.75 lakhs to the USA country. So why we add this much amount to the other countries? To come back, we can well ground up in all other technologies. So you have any point?
He has
a
problem
to say, right?
Yes, I agree with you. But in the world, India has most of the populations have been killing for one slave with you.
Yes, you also right. The partition, they take main road to creativity. So that's the reason why the main technological skill person, they move to other countries.
Yes.
Anyone has a point to it?
Finally, I want to conclude that, like a soldier serves our motherland, every individual should serve our motherland in the same way.
So finally, our motherland, Jai Hind.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Pranav. The GD went on well, but actually you are missing with anecdotes. That is, case studies are not brought into the discussion, and you're just beating around the bush at the same point. Especially Tirupati Rao, you have mother tongue influence, and your pronunciations have to be improved. And this person has not taken any chance to speak.
Number of the candidate, this person.
The candidate 2 hasn't taken the opportunity to speak. And the candidate 5 was very silent throughout the discussion. And I would appreciate Aditya as well as Janathan to take the lead role throughout the discussion. And Bharat, I think you